tutpad, we're bringing you this After Effects tutorial where we're going to show you how to use the Ease and Wizz plugin. The first thing we do is download the plugin here at aescripts.com. We're going to create a new account and fill in your personal details and your email address. You can check or uncheck these options if you want to subscribe or receive email notifications. Now select a password. And then we'll submit. Now we need to confirm the registration which has been sent to our email address. So if you go into your inbox, you should see it there. I'll go to mine and here it is. In the email, you have the link to confirm your account. So go ahead and click on that. It takes us straight into the new account where we can now download the plugin. If you want, you can add more details to your profile, but right now I just want to download Ease and Wizz. Go here to the search bar and type in Ease and click search. And here it is. So just click on it to open it. The interesting thing about this is that, as you can see here, we can name our own price. So we can pay whatever price we think is appropriate. The price that's indicated here is a suggestion. So if you just click on here, you can put your desired price. For this example, I'll put $5. And I'll add to cart. Okay. And here we have the details of our purchase. Let's proceed to checkout. In this case, I'm going to use my PayPal account. Fill in your billing details here. And once you've done that, you can continue to the payment information. As I said, I'm going to use PayPal. And this takes me to the PayPal website. And here I'll input my password and continue to process the payment. Click here to place the order. And as you see, our order has now been received and we can download the invoice. So now we're ready to download the plugin. Click on your name at the top here to go into your account. And now, click on My Downloads and Licenses. And here is our downloaded plugin, Ease and Wizz. On the right, click on Download. We get this window here telling us that we have the 2017 version. So click here to finally download the file. And we can now close this window. Okay, now we're going to learn how to install the plugin. So let's open the file and install the plugin. Right-click on this file and select Extract to extract it to a folder. Double-click on this folder and we have these files. The author has left us this PDF, which is a guide. What we need to do is add this file here and this one, Easing Expressions, to script UI panels inside After Effects. If you're a Mac user, this guide explains where it needs to go. In my case, I'm using Windows. I'll copy these two files and go to this PC, local disk, program files, Adobe, After Effects 2017, support files, and then I look for scripts. Here is the scripts UI panels folder. And once in here, Control V to paste our two files, and there they are. Now we can open After Effects to see how it works. So here, go to Window. Right at the bottom, you have Ease and Wizz. Select it. Press here on the title and drag it down right down here where you see the color changes and let it go. And now you see it's a panel that's part of our workspace, making it very easy and practical to use. You can even save the workspace just like this. So if you right-click up here, you can save changes to this workspace. And this way the plugin will always appear on my workspace. Okay, great. Now the plugin is installed, we can use it. I'll point out that you can also detach this window and place it anywhere you like on your workspace. For instance, I'll click on it and drag it over here to the project window. So let go and here it is. To be able to use Ease and Wizz, we need keyframes, either on the position, scale, or any other value for images, shape layers, or even paths. Basically, we can apply this effect to any kind of keyframe. Here, for example, I've added a keyframe to the position of each of these squares. So right-click, keyframe assistant, Easy Ease. So I'm going to change the color of the first square to this pink color. And when we preview, see that the pink one has a different animation to the yellow one. Why is that? This is because in the graph editor, I've adjusted the curve, so the animation gets quicker in the middle. And I still haven't applied any effect of the Ease and Wizz. But I want you to observe that if we apply any expression in the Ease and Wizz, then the graph editor won't have any value. It will follow or it will obey the effect that's been applied. So it doesn't matter that I adjusted the curve like this, because once I apply Ease and Wizz, it won't be of any use. So here on number one, select the position, and I'll go here to Easing and select Bounce. And then I'll apply it to the end so it bounces back. Apply. And see down here, the values appear in red. And as I said, this will no longer obey the shape of the curve in the graph editor. If you click here on this triangle, you can see the expression that's been applied. This plugin contains animation expressions saved as files. And we can apply these with a simple click. Okay, let's preview and see how the pink square now bounces back. To show you what I mean about this curve, it doesn't matter how much I adjust it, nothing will change as long as the Ease and Wizz effect is applied. The same animation continues. What would happen if I changed this to in and out? To change the effect, I don't need to delete this expression. Just select the position and click on Apply. And we can see down here that this has changed to in and out, and the text has also changed. Now, if we preview, you can see that it has a bounce at the beginning and another small bounce at the end. If I want to go back to the previous animation with a bounce just at the bottom, then just change this to out, select the position, and apply. And there you go. As you can see, there are different types of easing. For example, Expo, this makes it go down very quickly. And it's on out. If we select in and out, it will start off slowly, get faster, and end slowly again. Let's take a look. We also have Elastic. Let's see how it looks. Preview. If I take this keyframe up to second 3, for instance, Then let's see what happens. It has this, well, elastic effect, as its name indicates. Let's see what back does. If we apply it in out, then at the bottom it goes down a bit further and then back up again. We could change it to in and out. By the way, we can't see the expression here because it's minimized. So if you click here, you can see it. Now, apply to see the effect. At the top, it goes back a little bit before going down. And then at the bottom, it does the same as the previous effect. Let's go to square number 3. We have this animation. Select the position. In easing, we can also combine the different effects. So for example, elastic out, back in. Let's take a look. Does look a little bit odd. Let's try a different one, bounce out, expo in. Okay, it looks like it hits something and bounces back. So this is something that you can use in your own animations. Okay, some of the disadvantages of Ease and Wizz. One is that I can't place another effect here. So if I wanted to put a wiggle here, nothing would happen. The Ease and Wizz expression is the one that will be obeyed. But I'll give you a possible solution to this problem. Here I have two squares that are animated on the position. I'll select the lower square and apply an expo to the position. Let's preview to see the effect. Now I'll add an expression to the green square. Alt-click on position and type wiggle 35.3 and let's see what happens. This green square looks like it's wobbling and the other one zooms back and forth. So Ctrl-C to copy this expression. Now what happens if I place this wiggle here in the Ease and Wizz? So place it here at the bottom. Ctrl V to paste. Now as you can see, the wiggle has been applied to both squares and the Ease and Wizz no longer applies. So the disadvantage here is that we can't combine the expressions. Let's delete the top square. Ctrl X to get rid of the wiggle. And now the previous animation has been restored. So what can we do? Minimize this here. Right click, new, null object. And I'll name it Square Wiggle. Click on the eye to hide it. Go to the position, alt click, and place the wiggle expression here. So I had copied it, Ctrl V to paste. And now I'll parent this to the null object. And as you can see, the two effects have now been combined. And this was quite simple to do. Another difficulty is that if I apply this Ease and Wizz expression to the position, this will affect all the keyframes of this position. So for instance, I'll get rid of this. Now, this square goes here. I'll place a keyframe here, and I'll do this at the end. If we preview, at the moment it's just normal because I haven't applied any effect yet. I'll just adjust this curve slightly. So let's say that at this point, I wanted the square to move faster and then I wanted it to bounce. This is a problem. To go fast, I need to explore Expo. But, as you can see, it will apply to all the keyframes. And I can't change it to bounce, because if I do, then the bounce effect is also applied to all of the keyframes. There is something we can do about that. If we apply Expo, apply, right here, I'll press Ctrl-Shift-D to cut. Now press U to see the keyframes. And here, in position, apply bounce. Set the type to out so that it only affects the end. Okay, let's see what happened. And there it is. It starts quickly and finishes with a bounce. So yes, it is a disadvantage, but as you saw, all we had to do was cut, and then we can easily combine two different effects in Ease and Wizz. Remember we said that Ease and Wizz can be applied to any kind of value as long as it contains a keyframe. For instance, I have an ellipse here that's animated on the scale. So select the scale and apply the back easing, and then type out. And you can see that it gets bigger and then it shrinks back. Here I have the animation of a line on its trim path. Press U to see the keyframes. So I've applied trim path to give it this effect. If you select start and end, and then an easing quad, out, apply, let's take a look. And see how it gets slower right at the end. So you can see it's easy and it's practical. The examples I gave you at the beginning were all animations of the position, but just remember that you can apply these Ease and Wizz expressions to any value. If you want to learn how to use Ease and Wizz in a project, then check out my tutorial called Flat Logo Reveal on tutpad.com, where I'll use the plugin to help me in my project. If you wanted to delete any Ease and Wizz expressions, you just need to click on it and delete. Remember that if you don't see the expression, it's minimized. Just click here to see it. And there you go. Thanks for watching this After Effects tutorial. Check out tutpad.com for more courses and tutorials. Bye!